It's good to be back
Oh,
again.
yes. And we were just talking about how many couples prepare for the wedding and actually never prepare for the marriage. And that's why we have so many mistakes, because the wedding is just, it's not even part of the conversation. It's just like a celebration.
Yes, a big celebration. A big party is a big celebration. And after the celebration, you want to catch a breath and rest a bit, recoup from the spending.
I don't even mind if you're having the celebration, if you are prepared.
Yes.
But to have a big, prepare for a big celebration without being prepared for the marriage itself is the reason why we have so many divorces.
Yes, I'm supposed to say, let's take it one at a time. But they take it after the first one, they don't want to take the second one, which is the preparation for the marriage itself.
It should be taken before the wedding itself. Mm. Oh, welcome to today's relationship clinic. My name is Angel, I'm here with my husband.
And I'm Rich. It's good to be back here.
Oh, yes. We are discussing three common mistakes men
do
in marriage. Three common mistakes men do make in marriage. Last episode, we talked about three common mistakes women make in marriage. If you haven't listened, please, that is important. It will help you to balance today's conversation. And don't forget, subscribe. This Keeping Marriage Alive Initiative YouTube. Yes, click the button. Thank you. Share with your friends. Okay, we're back. And yes, we have other social media handles. You can tweet us. We're at our Twitter handle is Alive KMA, and Keeping Marriage Alive, Instagram and Facebook, BS Keeping Marriage Alive. Please follow us, share. Let's enrich our lives and, of course, build a healthier marriage.
Yes, it's very important. So what are the mistakes men do?
The first one, you know, we've already given you a little bit of the beef. The marriage is the wedding is the grand finale.
Yes.
Let's just get married. And what they are saying, get married, means let's have a big wedding.
Yes, then the rest will follow. To follow naturally. We're in love. We can work it out.
I don't get it. And women, I hope I'm speaking for us. And I'm speaking to the man here. Why is it that men are so, they want to get married? Sure, there was a story I heard last week that summarizes this first part of it. And this first, I want to just reiterate what this first is. He says the wedding is the ultimate prize. That is, just get married and not the marriage itself. Because the marriage is an unending
process,
exactly. Yeah. So a friend of mine shared something, and when she shared it, it's a summary of most of our marriages. So when she dated her husband for 8 years, and usually they take strolls, the keys, he sent her love letters, you know, he said, and it was like heaven on earth. She can come to his house, he gets into the kitchen, he makes a breakfast or dinner, you know. So after their wedding night, she was on the bed and the man said, get me water. She said, I can't get water for yourself now. The man said, you're no longer my girlfriend, though, you're my wife. And she couldn't understand.
The shock.
Because the truth of the matter is that why the woman said yes to you was because of the things you did.
And I expect them to continue.
So when you stop them, there is already a problem.
Now looks as we are pretending. Meanwhile, the man had a game plan to win. Then
because most men are so enthralled with the chase. So this lady, I can win her, I can get her and marry her. And when he's done, he says it's done. It's not done. The real work begins.
In reality, the real work begins.
I think we also went through that, though we didn't court and date. But I think my husband was excited that we're getting married.
Everybody was excited. Gradually, you now see that this thing requires work. And when I tell you this is part of the work you need to do, you say, really? I thought we had finished this section of work. But the real work really starts, and we need to humble ourselves and learn what the real work is and do them.
Yeah.
Knowing it is not enough, do them consistently.
I don't
we fall short in that. I'm about to catch my breath and continue. It's like climbing a mountain. You don't climb and rest. You keep climbing to get to the top. And when you get to the top, there are other mountains waiting for you.
Exactly. So what we want to remind you that most men, the chase for them is, oh gosh, she said yes, I do, we've gotten married, and then the marriage works itself. Now if you're married for a while, you know that marriage does not work itself.
It
if you're not working it's not working. hope this first, what do you think, read it, what do you think about it? And if you're a guy, I'm sure you're laughing right now. If that's true, oh, I'm in love with her, it's just to marry her. I need to do that. Mm-mm. Okay, so I hope you've enjoyed that. So men, you can also, you know, some men will say, so what's the thrill? What is the next thrill? When you set goals as a couple, you always have something to aspire for. Mm-hmm. So one of the things, you know, so the men say, but there's no thrill again.
We won the prize. Let's gotta relax.
So what we tell men when we come for counseling is you can also include goals that you win together. That keeps the thrill and also brings bonding into the marriage, learning one another. Has that helped? I hope you've understood this point. The goals keep the thrill in the marriage for the men who always are there to chase and the thrill. Yes, this is a more of a hard work, but the goal brings change, bonding, and of course, keep the thrill alive.
Yeah, something to look out for, something to look towards, something to still chase.
Yes. You know? And I just want to add that this is not part of it. Keep the chase in the marriage. Keep it going. You know, one of the reasons why your wife chose you was because she felt you were passionate about her. Don't let the passion die. Cleaving means chasing. Chase your spouse. Chike each other, as we Nigerians say it now, you know. And then the second one is, ha, my word is law. How many of you, you know, by the time you want, every woman I know that chose the man or agreed to say yes to a man always had this ideology that the man listened to them and listened to their ideas. Then you get married and the man just changes and says, my word is law.
I think the men get overwhelmed. They want to just say out their own idea without considering their wife's own idea and harmonizing it. They just want to say, this is how I want my home. This is how I want my home. Forgetting that the home is between two people. It's no longer your home as it were.
The truth of, I agree, but I also disagree in a way, because the truth of the matter is that, is it really that they want to speak, or is it because the society has told them that as the man of the house,
take charge. Part of that, the society has also been, take charge of your home.
And they say it in a very bad way, because there is no society that runs itself just by leadership.
Yes.
A leader must have a good follower. And the followers, if you don't have good followers, of course your leadership becomes a poor thing.
You must lean back and listen to your followers. That is the crux of it.
The truth of the matter is that most men, I've heard people say your husband should be cheered. Yes, cheer your spouse. Cheer your, both spouses should be cheered. Yes. But if there is a mistake, I think we should talk about it.
They should be corrected too.
So this second mistake, when men are offended when their words are no longer law. And sometimes at the younger time of marriage, women accept it. Then they grow older, their children begin to grow too, and they have a voice, more voices.
No, they discover the real truth. When you discover the real truth, you don't want to go back to, it's natural. You want to change. And the man is still there trying to say, what change are you doing? This is the law now.
So even God, every time my husband and I, of course, don't pretend, we this one that looks
the rough,
this young man, I even see that. I don't know why men tend to look very kind and calm outside. So they will listen to his vision too. Then he will come back. The law here.
I don't know where that one came from.
The law.
It's still marvel. And I think the underneath this is communication, our method of communication as men. I think that's where we're missing it. The method of communication as men. Because you can say the same thing in a more liberal way, giving room for the other person to even say, okay, this is good, this is not good. I think this man. Have a peaceful discussion. Peaceful disagreement, as you say, I don't agree that. I don't agree. So what do we do? Raising voices and trying to...
You know, it doesn't matter. Yeah? By the time you keep on insisting to have your way, what happens is that the woman begins to rebel.
Yes, there's friction already.
And then when she rebels, the children rebel. So what you wanted to build, you begin to destroy.
And if we're realistic, you can't even tell your adult child and command like that. It won't work.
In short, we are privileged to have our daughter being our videographer and editor for this season, this session, or rather, this episode. I can tell you, as she's smiling as I'm saying this, commanding her many times.
Missed the method.
So when she was 3, 4, 5 years, we could do that. Yes. We can't get away with that, even with her younger ones. So it's also, so we need to all look at that. Should my word be law? And some will say,
how can it be law? Do you know everything? You don't know everything.
Do you know that? I just want to share this scripture. I don't know if you've heard about the daughters of Zelophehad. You know, they came to Moses and said, this thing that all the property should be given to the men. We are five daughters and our father lived a good life. He died for other sins, not the sins others were punished for. And they requested for the property. Now, Moses took it to God, and God said, they are right. It baffles me that the all-knowing God, who has set a law, could step back humbly and say that this law I have set is not beneficial for the one I have set it. And I'm talking to the husbands. If you cannot take a stand and say, oh, I'm wrong in this thing I have said that must be done in our house, maybe then we have a big
problem. At least hear her out. Hear each other out.
Biko, at least hear is step one. Step two, please. Can we do something about the hearing now? Because many women have spoken, they are tired of speaking. We don't want to be heard any longer. We want you to listen and let's take action together.
No, but it starts from listening. And when you listen and understand the perspective and understand the intent of that conversation, can that's okay. So this has to be done this way. You fix your mind and do it.
Another thing I have to add to that is that there is this joke that goes on social media that is quite disheartening. Oh, you know, women like you to hear, so pretend as if you are hearing her. See, you're pretending that you're hearing her.
No, but that's worse. That will backfire.
Because at the end, you're losing your... Remember that there's something at stake here. Legacy is at stake. So I want you to remember that. Okay, I hope you've enjoyed
And women are computers. They will remind you the date, the time they told you that separately. And now say you are pretending to you had, you don't have it. You just get into confusion.
Oh, God.
Better listen and carefully.
So, what do you mean that we are computers?
They
so,
will tell you the time. No. They remember everything. They will tell you the time, the occasion. You yourself will know that you are in trouble. So you are pretending to hear. Don't try that. That's the wrong strategy.
I have some people that tell us as at that time, you know, in our olden days, our mothers listen to our fathers. Please stop. Number one was there was a very major age gap between mothers and fathers in their time.
Yes.
My mother and my father's age gap was 25 years. So in that concept, when you're having a conversation, the conversation will surely be different. Yes. So and we need to come to that place of understanding.
And we're not in those olden days. These modern things are happening. You want things to happen. You can't just go to those olden days. Can't
Yes, walk. And also, sometimes women got married at 13, 16, 17. And in the process of that marriage, what really usually happens is that these women have not found themselves, don't even know who they are. So they are like children who come and adapt to who you are.
Yes.
Now, in this generation, we have women who have found themselves, who understand right and wrong, who can survive without you, and then you make your word law.
It can work.
It's not even working here.
I'm not making my word law. Yeah.
Really? Really? He tried it.
Yes, I tried it occasionally. But obviously, I know, don't go there.
But we can negotiate, and yes. I defer to my husband, though I don't like it sometimes.
And truly, be even with your conscience, would you like to make someone unhappy persistently? You won't want to do that in normal state of mind and everything. You won't want to do that, and you are the cause. But at times when you are shouting, I don't know what takes over you. You just begin to shout and scatter the words.
You know, some men are so happy when they come home and everybody is hiding.
No. I don't think any man is. This is, you know. We need collaboration. We need help. You want a peaceful home yourself.
Are you sure?
No. Everybody wants a home. You can't be doing that now. Really.
And sure, that reminds me that if you're just joining in, please, there is a Facebook conversation we had on Monday on Watch for the Week. I think dying can also be possible.
Yes, we must all die.
Learn to die to seasons so that we can be alive for the new season. So back to our conversation. The third one. Oh, God. The third one is marriage brings freedom. I leave that to you. Oh, God.
And for we that grew up all boys, all men, you know, so we've not really had a deeper relationship with women before we got married like that. You know, where boys can say, I'm at Ibadano, I'll come back. Try it. You won't come back. You won't come back. There's no freedom. Freedom is negotiated.
I like that word. Freedom.
Every bit of it is negotiated.
Both husband and wife.
Sure. And that's where communication is the bedrock, really. You say, I want to go to Ibadan. When do you want to go? Tomorrow. Okay, are you sure tomorrow is good? You know, the woman will tell you her own point, her viewpoint. You know, it's just that all of us must learn the act of communication. I don't know. It's so crucial here. And must learn to weigh the other person's opinion.
That's true. That's true.
It's so easy to say, to do it.
I can tell you, when we got married, when my husband is going out, I ask him, where are you going to? Because he just dresses up and leaves. Then I don't know if he's at work. I don't know if he went to see friends. Then he comes back at night. And there was one crucial thing, you know, because with what's happening in society, and I can't even afford not to be accountable to one another.
I'm telling you.
And marriage, I think men actually felt. Women have that, but I think men have it more. Because we're always told as women, you know, you're preparing for your marriage, behave well so you get married. Men were never told those kind of conversations.
We're never told though.
So men get married.
Just go and get married. Go and get married.
You know, get married. As sure they will tell you, you get married so you can have someone that can help you cook. You know, they have different ideologies.
Get married first. As if when you get married, the rest will not follow. Instead of go and learn how to do marriage first.
Yes.
So get married, get married.
And that's
you're
reading,
getting old.
We didn't say rehearsal, we say go and read.
Yes.
Have female friends even hear people's side of their conversations.
Yes. Even stay with married couples and watch and ask interactions because these things are real. They are real.
So most people, when you now have a wife that's asking you certain questions, you say they are controlling. Marriage in itself is responsibility. The freedom is always negotiated.
Yes.
And I like that word. I have to really borrow it today. So when you look at your marriage and you see a man, you say, this man is so free. I can't wait to get married.
The man is not free. He's responsible.
Hallelujah.
Very responsible.
And then the woman says, I remember a friend of mine, she said her daughter used to admire her when she was going to work. So her daughter now got a job as a banker too. And one day after 1 year, called her mom and said, this is slavery. Let me tell you, marriage requires a depth of responsibility that if you can't give, please don't go into it. Hope you've enjoyed these three common mistakes. And I will share some other mistakes we overlooked.
Yes, there are several mistakes actually, but these are three common ones
that
you can, everybody can relate to.
There's another one I wanted to share, and I'm looking for it. Oh, God. Every one of us gets married thinking that the other will complete us. It's a common mistake both parties make.
The other one has come in there to turn you and juggle you and turn you inside out
before
you're not complete.
So remember that if you're not complete, marriage will not complete you. For both the husband and the wife. Our completeness is found in Jesus. And I want to remind you, it's found in your relationship with God, your maker, your creator. And then we begin to walk together. Someone asked us a question in one of the churches we handled some years back, and I will repeat my the question and the answer. The person said, so who wins when we have conflict in marriage? Now I want to say to you, none of us don't
win. Marriage wins, not
yes,
none of us wins.
We don't win, the marriage wins. And that is the best way to keep your marriage.
And that should not be the aim for someone to even win.
Mm-hmm.
I know when you're arguing, you want to win.
Mm-hmm.
But that should not be the aim.
Mm-hmm.
What is best for the marriage at that time and in that situation?
Exactly. Hope you've enjoyed these few common, three common mistakes men make.
So stop making those mistakes.
My husband, did you make them?
I've made them over and over and over. But God is helping me. God is still helping me.
And if you've made them, it's not too late to begin to readdress them.
Yes.
It begins with understanding that you're a partner, you have a co-partner who you're accountable to. It's not, doesn't diminish you as a man. It actually shows that your love and worth. Do you know God actually said to his angel, he said, I cannot make this decision without my friend Abraham.
That's accountability. That's accountability. And God said, let us make, he invited him. He doesn't do a work alone.
Okay. So thank you, everyone. Don't forget to subscribe. Follow us on social media. I hope you've really enjoyed this. Stay blessed.
Yes, don't miss out on the Family and Life Bootcamp happening this year.
Yes.
From April.
Easter break. If you've ever joined us, please share your comments. It's been a wonderful time. And the theme for this year is strengthening the family bond. We need you to be there. Don't let someone tell you the story. It's an eye-opener, it's a healing process. And of course, the value of family is, you know. I remember that young boy that shared his testimony. Though he has gone on vacation with his parents, he said this is a real vacation.
He went now.
Because his parents were able to relate with him, they were able to share things together. So don't miss it. DM us. You can call and get your family size and of course pay. And be there, it's in Ibadan. We are painting Ibadan.
Red! See you next week.
Bye.